Out of her separate self, she looked and saw. Now she is becoming little yogic. You see, the whole quality of Savitri's grief, the whole quality of Savitri's conflict is that itself is turning into her yogic poise. Is turning into a yogic poise, you see. That is the important thing, you see. It is not human passion, human violence, nothing at all. The grief itself is turning into a yogic quality, you see. So out of a separate self, she looked and saw moving amid the unconscious faces loud, all the people which are there around, they are not aware of what is going to happen tomorrow. See, they are taking life in a usual manner. They are carrying on their daily activities in a usual manner, moving amid the unconscious faces loud, in mind a stranger, though in heart so near, the ignorant smiling world go happily by. You see, everybody is carrying on their whole world. See, but Savitri, what is going to happen tomorrow to Savitri? Of that they have absolutely no idea, no hint at all, you see. So they are happily going on with their daily things, you see. The ignorant smiling world, that is what we are. The ignorant smiling world go happily by upon its way towards an unknown doom and wondered at the careless lives of men. Wondered. Who wondered? Savitri wondered. How these people can really smile and live and do their daily activities like that at all, when the doom is standing very close to them, you see. She is wondering at that. Now, all that she is watching, not with a passion, that I am grieving and you fellows, you chaps, merrily, happily doing all kind of things, is not that vital passion at all. She is seeing the whole thing in a very calm, detached, isolated manner, as if she is not really affected by anything at all. That is the quality of the separate self of Savitri. She can stand away from her outer nature and live within, and from that see the whole thing. Now this phrase, separate self, is a very significant phrase, and we have number of occurrences of separate phrase in Savitri. There are eight occurrences of this phrase, separate self, in Savitri. Now what is separate self? Now here we have got separate self. Its units also act in ignorance of each other and of the cosmic whole, except for the knowledge that they can get by contact, by communication. The basic sense of identity and the mutual penetration and understanding that comes from it are no longer there. The basic sense of understanding and penetration is not there. The character persists in life and the subtle matter, etc. Then he is talking of the overmind descent. Well, let's here we have these eight passages from Savitri about the separate self. Well, let me just quote 10.17, separate self, where it occurs. 10.17. Now you can get the context of the, you see, this is a yogic term. Separate self is a yogic term. This is an important term. It describes a certain yogic psychological state. You see. See, let us read this one, 104.12. This is the meeting of Satyavan and Savitri. They are joining together. They are pledging to be together. She is putting a garland in the neck of Satyavan. Satyavan is going to embrace all that we have seen in the book of love. So, first part is, in a wide moment of two souls that meet, she felt her being flow into him as in waves, a river pours into a mighty sea. That is how she is pouring herself into him. As when a soul is merging into God, to live in him forever and know his joy, her consciousness was a way of him alone, and all her separate self was lost in his. So that is the kind of a separation that also goes away in that union of love, you see. All her separate self was lost in him, in his. This is important. See, this is absolutely yogic. 128.3132. See, here the little background is like this about this passage. Savitri has found her soul. This is 5th canto of the book of Yoga. Savitri has found her soul. After finding the soul, she is now experiencing something different. The divine Shakti herself is entering into her subtle physical body. Center after center are now occupied by divine Savitri. All the chakras are getting now charged with the presence of divine Savitri. So the Kundalini has descended into Savitri from above down below. She had discovered her soul. The divine force now has entered and is now occupying all her centers in the subtle physical. But of course, that is a very great siddhi, realization of Savitri, finding the soul and the divine force entering into the physical. But that is not sufficient for Savitri's work. Finding the soul is not sufficient for Savitri's work. Even the presence of the divine force in her body is not sufficient, because she has to meet death. Now, all that is of ignorance, of inconscience in her nature, that should also get removed. The divine presence cannot be there if your physical, your mental, your vital are still governed by the laws of inconscience and ignorance. And with their presence, death can simply swallow her up. You see, if she Savitri is still governed by the inconscient laws of nature, then it's very easy for death to sort of swallow her up, you see. So it is not sufficient for Savitri to simply get the divine force and establish in her body, in her physical, you see. Even her physical nature now should open out. The very vital, mental, physical has to open out to the divine presence and divine force. Rather, for that thing to happen, what Savitri has to do, she must empty herself out fully. All that is inconscient, all that is ignorant, etc., etc., they have to go away from her. That is the nirvana. Savitri must empty herself out fully, attain that nirvanic condition. And when she is empty fully, then God can come and reside in her. Then she is really the master of that thing. So that transition now from the discovery of the soul and the Kundalini getting established here, Savitri faces, because of this human nature, the inconscient nature, a dread. the dread comes to Savitri in the form of a voice and challenges, who are you? You think that you have attained something very great? Establishing the divine force in your body, in your subtle physical, you think it's very great? He's challenging. So a cry of the abyss drew heaven's reply. From below, that cry is coming out and replying heaven. A mighty storm chased by the might of the sun. Both of them are now constantly there. O soul, Savitri is told, O soul, bear not thy kingdom to the foe. Don't expose your soul, your gain, your siddhi, your attainments, realization. Don't expose to others, to the foe, to the enemy. In fact, that is constantly being told to us also. Those who are getting spiritual realization, they should hold them entirely to themselves. Do not utter them. They can get squandered away. They can get lost also, you see. It is necessary to hold them. Don't expose them to the foe. Bear not thy kingdom to the foe. Consent to hide thy royalty of bliss. Yes, you attain great bliss, but hide it. Don't expose it. Don't show it off. Don't strut around with that bliss, you see. Lest time and fate find out its avenue and beat with a thunderous knock upon thy gate. Time and fate will come if you start exposing all those things. You have to have really some capacity to hold them entirely to yourself. You have to be a good adhara, support to hold, contain all that divine gain which you have got. Hide while thou can that treasure of separate self. That separate self which you have now gained, you hide it from others. Don't expose it at all to others, you see. Don't. Behind the luminous rampart of thy depths, till of a vaster empire it grows part. So, yes, you have attained, but please keep it entirely to yourself. Till of a vaster empire it grows part. When it really becomes a part of the universal master thing, then you can go and really talk about that thing, but not until then. You see, not until then. There is a danger. It can take wings and disappear, you see, all your spiritual realizations, you see. So, in fact, that is the one of the basic conditions of sadhana. If you have achieved something, keep it to yourself. When you are really confident, mastered, is a part of your personality, then maybe you can talk about it, but not until then, you see. Not until then. Out of a separate self, she looked and saw. See, this is the condition now. See, now just imagine, at the very early stage, Savitri is swaying between grief and happiness, but now she has detached herself entirely from all those moments, all those actions. Out of a separate self, she looked and saw, moving amid the unconscious faces loud, in mind a stranger, though in heart so near, the ignorant smiling world go happily by upon its way towards an unknown doom, and wondered at the careless lives of men, obviously, see. As if in different worlds they walk, this Savitri is walking in another world, and these people are walking in another world. As if in different worlds they walk. Though crows, they confident of the returning sun, they wrapped the little early hopes and tar. She, in her dreadful knowledge, was alone. Yes, the doom. Nobody knows around that, you see. The rich and happy secrecy that once enshrined her, as if in a silver bower, apart in the brightness of thoughts and dreams, made room for tragic hours of solitude and lonely grief that none could share or know, a body seeing the end too soon of joy and the fragile happiness of mortal love. Fragile happiness of mortal love. This is what we are, you see. This is what we are, you see. Her quiet visage. See, her quiet visage. Although she is now passionate, she is swaying between grief and happiness constantly. Yet her face, her personality, her poise is absolutely quiet. Her quiet is still and sweet and calm. Her graceful daily acts were now a mask. In vain she looked upon her depths to find a ground of stillness and a spirit's peace. Still veiled from her was a silent being within. She is looking for something. She has become very calm and quiet. She is looking for something. But the silent being who will guide her, he is veiled, he is covered. Who sees life's drama pass with unmoved eye, supports sorrow of the mind and heart, and bears in human breast the world and fate. A glimpse of flashes came, the presence was hid. All the silent being, sometimes Savitri gets a little glimpse, some kind of a flash comes, but that very presence of the silent being is absent. The silent being is not present at all, is absent. The presence is absent.